whatever situation you may be in, this poem may fit you for an inspiration. If you do nothing else in this life, have a competition with yourself. You've got the help from the greatest teachers, coaches, and leaders. Grandma would say out loud, "Dance, my child. I'm watching and I'm proud. Stick with it. Do your best. Because if you're missing class, you're doing less." Visualize. Dance deep down from your core. Give your all. Give more. Watch, practice, learn. And when it's your turn, you'll have the confidence because you follow teachers with the power to discern. But never think you've done just enough. Keep going. Kick your own butt. Don't get sidetracked with friends and back up. Feel it in your bones and muscles. Sweat. That's when you know you've hustled. Fly high, jump, and touch the sky. And when tormented by things that bring you sadness, allow your dance to chase away the madness. Focus on your skills, stretch daily, and although I lay her ill, I will live. Live on in you. It's about staying true to your art, which comes from the heart. Continue your dance. Pass on your gifts to lift another soul, because you never know who's in that audience you're helping to heal, to grow.
True story. I wrote this poem for a dancer who was coming to class, but she was not participating. After the third day of watching her sit in the corner with her head held down, I asked her after class, "Why are you not dancing?" She said, "I don't want to dance. My grandma is in the hospital sick, and she's always taking care of me." This girl was in tears, and I felt her pain. That hit a nerve with me because I love my grandma, and I know how it is. I was following this girl in class, but she had no idea I was watching her. I wrote this poem that same day. I called her up and read the poem over the phone to her. She was back dancing the next day.
HarrisDavisDean.com